let's continue the poem. No men are foreign. Before I proceed, I would ask you to explain. Clear? So you'll be coming here. I'll be calling you near the mic so that you can speak today. Okay? I want to see those who have listened to me carefully. So it's you will be raising hand. Who will explain first stanza, which we did yesterday? Explain first stanza. I want to see so many hands. Now nobody is raising hand. I said you will be speaking here. So Daria, you want to? You are raising hand and then you are... Yes, you want to speak? Very good. Come. Come here. So what? Okay, I'll be doing mic here. I won't be showing you. You are hesitant of coming in front of the camera. Come here. Just speak. Speak here. Okay, stand here and speak. Come. Divya, come. It means you people are hesitant of speaking in mic. Come. So Divya will be giving the answer. Divya, you can come. Hold it and then speak. Yes, so Divya is going to explain first stanza than yesterday. Yes.
Everyone is equal and no, there is no difference in comparison of caste, religion, and the color. We come from the same place and we will be going to the same place where we came from.
So, poet is suggesting us to create differences, or we should take everything that all are equals. What is the question? Yes.
We should consider everyone equal.
So, message of equality is given. Thank you. Anybody else would like to? It's very easy to speak from there. You know, you people are talking and looking at each other as if you're on a picnic. You're coming to school to learn only. So first stanza, poet says, this is a revision, then we'll continue. That poet, James Kirkup says that, remember, no men are strange, no countries are foreign. Beneath, under all the uniforms, a single body breathes. So we all are same in one or the other way. The way one person breathes, the other also breathes. The way you eat, others eat. All are same, right? So like us. So land of our brothers walk upon is earth like this in which we all shall lie. So we take birth. And we, when we die, we will be buried in the same earth. So we are all equals in one way. There is no difference. So God has not created differences. Differences are man-made, created by men. Second stanza, who will explain from there only, if you don't want to come here. Raise your hand and speak. Second stanza, you can keep in front of you. Online children, if you want to speak, you can raise your hand. Online children. You can explain if you want to. Yes, Tiksha wants to speak. Better kindly speak louder, okay? So that others can also listen to you. So Tiksha, I have given third stanza. You can. Yes, Tiksha, louder.
Third stanza?
Second stanza. Second.
Okay. This stanza explains that all the person in living in this world are aware of sun and air and water. They all need basic natural resources. They are fed by the act of collecting grains. When our soldiers are at the war place, they die due to starvation or cold climatic conditions. Their hands are ours and the lines we read. The way they work hard, everyone work hard. The labor is not different from our own. A person working in air-conditioned room is not different from the person who is making the houses.
That was the example given, okay? So you need not write that. You can mute yourself to picture. So that was the example I gave. You cannot give the explanation like that. So it is written in the second stanza that they too aware of sun and air and water means all the human beings on this earth. They use same natural resources. sun, air and water, which is required by every human being. So our needs are basically same. And all are fed by peaceful harvest. The kind of food we eat, we are dependent upon harvest, production, crops and all. Similarly, everyone is dependent. You're continuously talking to this girl. You will be exploring thoughts, Tanza, then. So, by wars, long winters starve, their hands are ours, and in their lives, lines we read, a labor not different from our own. So, whosoever is working hard, people, hard work at one nation is equal to hard work at another nation. Fine. So everybody is putting in efforts in one or the other way. So poet is trying to say hard work is done by all the people. Clear? So there is no difference which is created by God. The kind of food we eat, they also eat. The kind of sun, air, water we need, they are also using. So similarly, the kind of hard work they are doing, that is also same. So he's trying to bring out the point of similarity that we all are same in one or the other way. Third stanza, will you explain now? Continuously you were talking as if you know everything. Yes, Jatin, you want to speak? Hanji, boliye. Fine. So in third stanza, poet gives us a reminder that everybody has eyes which wake up and sleep. So natural process, waking up and sleeping, we are having same features, fine, body parts actually is trying to say, and strength that can be won by love. So nobody can say that I cannot win anyone. Any person can be one with the feeling of love. If you talk lovingly to others, definitely they are going to be your friends. So he's trying to say the emotion of love is the most important emotion of all, which can win even the person who do not like you. You can win any person out of sheer emotion of love. So importance of love is told here, that there is nothing in hatred, jealousy and war like circumstances. Love is the most overpowering emotion. So in every land is common life that all can recognize and understand. So everybody is leading the same life. You can recognize yourself with others. The man-made differences, now we say we are different, Indians are different, Pakistanis are different. So there is no difference. When you start realizing that the appearance might differ, attire might differ, but beneath all the kinds of clothes, the same kind of body and soul and emotions and hard work is there. Clear? So we are same. Let's continue with stanza 4. Let us remember. So poet gives a reminder to all of us, including himself. Whenever we are told to hate our brothers, it is ourselves that we shall dispossess, betray, condemn. Remember, we who take arms against each other. So poet is trying to say that give yourself a reminder. Whenever we are told you should hate this person because he's like this, we should hate that country because this is enemy country. So poet is saying that whenever we are told to hate anyone, actually we are projecting our own negativity here. Fine, wo kehte hai na ki jaisi aapki soch hoti waisi aapko sabhi lagna shuru ho jate hain. We say the person is very bad. Actually, our thinking is bad. It's all in our mind. So poet is trying to say that it actually projects our own negativity, our own betray. Betray is to cheat others. Condemn. What do you mean by condemn? When you, yes, criticize. Very good. When you criticize others, when you condemn others, actually, you are projecting your bad side only by doing that. Clear? When you spread hatred, that is your true picture, not others. So remember, we who take arms against each other. So we are the ones who initiate war-like circumstance. We are the ones who create hatred. Nobody else. But we never take charge or responsibility of this thing. Clear? So poet here is saying that we all are, you can say, same in one or the other way, but whenever anybody is spreading hatred, that is our own side, nobody else is asking us. So that is a projection of our wrong side. Next stanza, it is the human earth that we defile. See, the meaning of defile is given. Meaning of defile is given. Make dirty or pollute. It is written in your book only. Defile means to pollute. Our hells of fire and dust outrage the innocence of air that is everywhere our own. Remember, no men are foreign and no country strange. So, yes. Hells of fire is a metaphor used for, or a symbol used for, war-like situations. So when war will be there, many people will die, many innocent lives will be lost. So that becomes hell only. Hell of fire, hell of destruction. And dust outrage the innocent. Dust is our misconceptions and hatred. Our brain is having the dust of hatred, hating others, fine. So poet is saying, and if it is a human earth that we defile, we are destroying and polluting the earth. We are making it dirty by our dirty behavior, by spreading hatred, by spreading jealousy, by, you know, punishing others or becoming vicious. We are polluting that. You can say we are filled with the dust, outrage the innocence of air. Otherwise, see, when a child is there, when a child, I'm just giving example, this is not mentioned here. When a child is born, he's like a clay only. If you start teaching that differences, color-based differences, jaise usko banaoge, wo waise hi ban jayega. So the way you raise a child, the way you mold him or her, they become like that only. So poet is saying these man-made differences are there. God has not created any difference. Of air that is everywhere our own. Air is same. Wherever at any place in the world you go, everybody's breathing air only, innocent air. And we are spreading hatred and jealousy and we are ruining it. We are making it dirty. Fine. And what will happen if our air is dirty? We will breathe it in the same air. Metaphorical meaning yahi hai. When there is hatred, jealousy in the air, we will also breathe the same air, and one or the other way, we will also become like that. Remember, no men are foreign and no country strange. So that at the last, again, he repeats that no men are different from us and no countries are peculiar, no countries are weird or strange. It's our thinking only. Clear? So let's do some question answers. Page number 81, beta. Online children, send your feedback if you are able to listen to me. Question answers we are going to discuss. You can note down the value points if you want. Page 81, first question. Beneath all uniforms, what uniforms do you think the poet is speaking about? What do you mean by the uniforms here? Yes, fine. You have, yes, it is right that whenever you go to Gujarat, people will be wearing different dress. You go to South, attire is different. In Punjab, it is different. In foreign countries, it is different. But beneath different attires, the human body and the soul and the kind of features you have, this is same everywhere. Fine. So this is what poet is trying to say. The poet speaks about the various dresses that people of various countries wear. The poet speaks about the various dresses or attires, attires. Attire means also dresses. Poet talk about various attires or dresses. Yes. Worn by different people in different countries. So poet is trying to project the idea that beneath means under such uniforms, under such dresses, the body is just same. Clear? The human body is just the same. So this is what poet is. But I'm not making you write. I'm discussing. You just note down the points and make it on your own. Next is, how does the poet suggest that all people on earth are same? All answers. Yes, so many points are there. Anybody else who want to answer? Ek do bachche bol rahe hain, baki sab aise hi baithe hain. Yes? Yes, eyes are same. Land, air and sun. So many examples are there. Poet says that nobody is different and peculiar. Right? Nobody is different and strange. No country is foreign. Fine. He's saying that a single body breathes beneath all. They also inhale the same air others are inhaling. They also use the same natural resources like sunlight. And they also are dependent upon food the way we are. Clear? So this is the idea given by the poet. Koi bhi example beta likh lo usme. They are saying, how does the poet suggest that all the people on earth are same? Poet says that all are same because they firstly live on the earth. When they die, they are buried in the earth. They eat the food only. They inhale the air only. Fine. So many points are there. You can write any 3 to 4 points you can mention. Second question. In stanza number 1, find 5 ways in which we all are alike. We have same kind of body, fine. We wear same kind of clothes. We walk on the same planet. And we are buried in this earth. We discuss here, same thing is there. In the first stanza, but poet is asking. First stanza ko aapne dekhna hai, not others. Clear? Firstly, we all have same body. We have same uniform. No, food is not mentioned in first stanza, beta. We walk on the same earth. We are buried in the same earth. Fine, 4 or 5 points are done in the first stanza itself. Next is, how many common features can you find in stanza 2? Ab second stanza ka aapne batana hai. Words. The following common features are given in the stanza's following words. Sun, air, water, harvest, same hands also it is mentioned. Same hands, labor not different from us. Labor also you can, same labor. Beta second. Hanji. Beta nahi, that is not the way they are saying long sagun. No. Sun, air, water, harvest, and labor. Next is, whenever we are told to hate our brothers, when do you think this happens? Why? Who tells us? Should we do as we are told at such times? What does the poet say? In this question, there are n number of questions, 4 or 5 parts. Abhi bhi dhyan nahi hai. I'm saying in the last question, 4 or 5 things they have asked. Firstly, they are saying, sometimes some people in power or some selfish people, who told you to hate others? Some selfish people who have selfish motives. Suppose some political leader is there. Aapne abhi aise likhna nahi hai political leaders. I'm just giving you example. Sometimes some leaders are there who start spreading hate for their self. They want voting and all. So they can be considered. But you cannot name any profession here. Fine. So you will be writing. Sometimes some selfish people, they instigate, they provoke innocent people, fine, to harm others. And why they do it? They do it for their own personal बेनिफिट्स. तो आपने हु का आंसर दे दिया. लेट मी कंप्लीट. ठीक है, जो भी क्वेरीज है. एंड कॉमन मैन डज नॉट अंडरस्टैंड द ट्रिक्स ऑफ दीज क्लेवर पीपल. ही फॉल्स इन टू द ट्रैप. फाइन. He starts thinking about it and acting upon it. So this is how hatred is spread. And why? For the selfish motives. Fine. They just want to fulfill their own selfish motives. Who tells us some selfish people for their personal benefits or motives? And should we do as we are told at such time? No. We should not follow others blindly. We should not follow others blindly in their personal motives. We should apply our brain. We should know what is good for us. We should be able to differentiate between good and bad. Bus. We should be able to differentiate between good and bad. So the poet says that people of the entire world are same. Last ka answer yehi hai. The poet repeatedly says and stresses upon the thing that we all are same in one or the other way. Now some extra questions with a stanza based. Stanza based. Additional questions pehle thoda likh lo. What is the message conveyed by the poet? Write down. This better these questions also in 30-40 words, 3-4 lines, okay? What message is conveyed by the poet? Additional questions likh lo. What message is conveyed by the poet? Yes, these questions you should do, right? You have to do. Haan, ye 4 questions from the book, 81 page, to be done in the notebook. 2-3 extra questions I'll make you write. Write down. Anji? Yes, additional questions just for the practice sake. What message does the poet want to convey? Poet wants to say that we all are same in one or the other way. We should not create differences on the basis of color, caste, dress, etc. No discrimination should be there. Clear? We should discourage spreading hatred and we should treat everyone equally. Uska stress main isi pe hai. We should treat everyone equally. We should discourage hatred or negativity in the society. और इनइक्वालिटी एनीथिंग यू कैन राइट. दिस इज नॉट की जो मैंने बोला वही लिखना है आपको. वी शुड डिस्करेज हेट्रेड इनइक्वालिटी एटसेट्रा और अदर माल प्रैक्टिसेस आल्सो. बेटा माल प्रैक्टिसेस क्या होते हैं? इफ आई एम सेइंग वेट इफ आई से वी शुड स्टॉप अदर माल प्रैक्टिसेस मींस not about slavery. All the negative things, hatred, jealousy, inequality, differences create karna, fine, fight karna, all the negativities. We should not spread all the malpractices. Like, phir aage bata dena kuch. Next question. Next question, beta. How are we responsible for war? How are we responsible for war? Not like this. Raise your hand and then speak. Hanji, boliye. How we are responsible for creating war? Discrimination only. Difference create karo. But every one of us is responsible for war. If we will start discriminating on the basis of race, color, caste, region, fine, or religion also, then warlike circumstances will prevail definitely. Yeah. So poet is trying to say that everyone is responsible for war. But ऐसे मेरे को याद नहीं मैंने क्या बोला है that way. उसको बता दो. उसकी बेटा बैल हो चुकी है. And Monday is the notebook submission day.